大家好，欢迎收看今天的KaKa Chinese 的 Culture Show， 我是 Vera。
Welcome to the KaKa Chinese Culture Show, I'm Lawrence.
So today we are going to talk about a very useful skill, that is how to become warm Chinese speakers when you are texting.
Exactly. 我们今天要教给大家非常实用的小技巧，怎么样在发短信、发微信 texting 的时候让你显得很暖。
The topic comes from like my personal experience. 就是前几天我的老公给我发微信。
So a couple of days ago, your husband was texting you.
他发了呵呵。
Oh my goodness, 呵呵。
对，呵呵 ,that 呵呵。
How old is he, may I ask?
就三十，跟我差不多三十多。
三十多人应该知道呵呵 is like taboo.
但是他就是不知道。So that's why, like, I decided to make this episode to teach you how to text.
So we have a list of 5 do's and don'ts when you are texting in Chinese.
And the first one is about this 呵呵。If you look up in the dictionary, it will tell you that 呵呵 is just like a sound of like a smile or laugh.
Laughter.
So
yeah.
That's why like a lot of people will use this when they're texting. But actually,
as a matter of fact, on the internet, 呵呵, if you're texting somebody else, 呵呵, you're as if smiling to that person, but somewhat reluctantly. So the connotation is definitely negative.
对的。So when I received this 呵呵 from my husband, the first thing I have is, are you unsatisfied with me? So what's wrong with me or what's wrong with us?
So that sort of pissed you off.
对，就是呵呵。And then when I realized he just misused this word, and I told him, 不要用呵呵，以后用哈哈。
哈哈, yeah, 哈哈 is totally safe, yeah.
对的。So when you want to say, okay, I'm happy and this smile face,
yeah,
you can send 哈哈 instead. Or another word is 嘿嘿。
嘿嘿, yeah.
对，哈哈和嘿嘿都可以。
Yeah.
但是不要呵呵。
不要呵呵。
And then the number 2 on the list is similar to this 呵呵, that is...
An emoji, which is the smiley face, which is the most basic smiling face, yeah.
对的，就是这个 smiley face. Yeah. So this emoji is very basic. It just looks like a smile face. So some people will think, okay, when I want to say I'm happy or like I agree with you, I can send this emoji like a smile face.
But if you really look at it, I mean, look at this emoji here.Doesn't look like a little bit, you know, reluctant to you? So a lot of young people in China, they use it as a reluctant smile. So it's also negative.
对的。So it's similar to the 呵呵。
Yeah.
就是 when I have this face, I'm saying, okay, 你高兴就好。
Yeah, it's something like, yeah, as long as you are happy. But if you are texting someone older than 40, I think it's pretty much safe to use this, the basic smiley face emoji.
就是老年人不懂网络的世界吗？
对 ，But 如果你在 texting your friend who's in their 20s, be sure to avoid this emoji.
是的。Okay, the number 3 on our list is this word, all. So all used in the daily life, which means that I got it, like okay. So if we use that face to face, it's totally okay. For example, if I say Lawrence, could you please help me to print this out?
Oh.
Yeah, that's pretty polite and pretty like common.
Yeah, it's pretty commonplace. Totally okay.
Then what's wrong with this all when texting?
It sounds a little bit nonchalant, like pretty indifferent when you are using just single character to text back.
对的。So when we use this all, if there is like just a text, if there's no tone or no appearance, no person's face, sometimes it will sound like very...就很冷漠，
很冷漠 ，very indifferent, right?
For example, Lawrence, can you help me to print this out?
So remember, when you're texting, you are not the person who's pronouncing or like interpreting how the other person comprehend the word. They're reading the word themselves in their mind. So,
是的、yeah. 所以不要用 all. Instead, you can use this word, It seems like un doesn't have this usage, like indifferent usage.
Yeah, I think un sounds a lot warmer. And if you want to appear even more friendly, you can text un.
So every time when I like say, Lawrence, could you do this? Could you do that? Mm-hmm. 他会说对的，所以or is much safe.
Mm-hmm.
And then number four on our list is the phrase 好吧. This is not just a problem like when you texting, but a lot of learners will make this mistake because 好吧 means okay, but it's not okay.
Yeah, a lot of people think 好吧 is the equivalent of 好的, but they're not.
对的，so 好吧 is okay, but I don't have any other choice. I accept that it's okay, it's fine.
So the character 吧 you add to the word 好 actually suggests a sense of reluctance. I'm doing this, I'm saying this because I have no other choice. I have to, I feel like I'm forced.
对的 So if your boss told you or if your girlfriend tell you to do something, please don't text 好吧.
Yeah, never say 好吧 or text back 好吧.
Okay, so the last one on our list is a tip, like how to make you sound more warm.
Yeah.
This is to use this a la ya at the end of your texting.
For example, when you're trying to turn down somebody else's offer, you can say 我不想去 but it sounds kind of a little bit aggressive.
对，就很也是比较 neutral 的嘛。So you can use a la at the end of the sentence.我不想去啦。
So it's a little bit cutesier.
对的, that's like a refuse, but more mild and soft. So sometimes if you are a man, if you use this la and ah at the end of the sentence, like when you are speaking, it will sound a little bit, you know, girly, like too cute.
Yeah.
But if it's texting, it's totally
okay.
Yeah,
it's totally fine. If you're a guy, you want to say, 我不想去啦。
对的，我不想去啦。So this is like a tip for you to become more polite or become more warm.
A warmer person, yeah.
是的。Okay, so I hope these five tips will help you when you're texting in Chinese.
If you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment below. And also, if you are an English speaker and you have some English tips to share with us to help us become better English texters, so leave us comment too.
如果你喜欢我们的节目，记得要订阅我们的频道哦。
If you like our show, please subscribe to our channel.
如果你想要更多学习内容，也可以去 kakachinese.com.
If you want more content like this, please visit us at kakachinese.com.
下次再见啦。
See you next time.